Welcome friends in your own channel US Physics. Let us learn today an important topic, magnets and their properties, from the chapter Magnetism. The substances which attract iron, nickel, cobalt and produce magnetic fields are called magnets. Uses of magnets in daily life. The most commonly magnets are used into following applications. Screwdrivers can easily attract iron nails because to the one end of it a magnet is placed. Fridge magnets. The different decorative hooks attached to the door of fridge are magnetic. Speakers. The magnetic speakers use a magnet to produce mechanical vibrations or sound. Magnetic compass is an instrument used for navigation. It consists of a magnetic needle. The magnetic resonance imaging is a medical imaging technique used in radiology to form pictures of anatomy and physiological process of the body in both health and diseases. Now discuss brief history of the magnets. The magnets were initially found in Magnesia region of Greece in the form of minerals which were locally called lodestones. Lode means to attract. The minerals attracting iron nails were named lodestones. Lodestone minerals were primarily found in Magnesia region of ancient Greece and hence were called magnets. Commonly used shapes of magnet are as follows. The most commonly used shape is bar magnet or disc magnet, U-shaped magnet and magnetic needle. Poles of a magnet. The strength of magnet to attract iron is not distributed uniformly but is concentrated at ends. These ends are called as poles. Poles of magnet. Each magnet has two poles, namely north pole and south pole. The poles of magnet has got some definite properties. The unlike poles of magnet attract each other. The north is attracted towards south and the south pole is attracted towards north. Whereas the like poles of magnet repel each other. The north repels north and the south repels the south. Directional property of magnet. If a magnet is freely suspended and balanced, then it always comes to rest along geographic north-south direction. The pole of magnet seeking geographical north is called north pole and the pole of magnet seeking geographical south is called south pole of the magnet. The directional property of the magnet is used in magnetic compass, which is used to find direction at any place on the surface of Earth. Magnet
as magnetic dipole. The unipolar magnet does not exist. If we break a magnet into two halves, then each half still behaves as if it is a complete magnet. Break the pieces in halves again, and you will have four complete magnets. Even if the piece is one atom thick, there are two poles. This suggests that atoms themselves are magnets. Thus, magnets always exist with two poles, and hence called magnetic dipole. Geometric properties of magnet. Number 1, geometric length. The length between ends of a magnet is called geometric length. It is denoted by capital L. Magnetic length. The poles of magnet are not situated exactly at ends, but little inside. The distance between two poles of a magnet is called magnetic length. Thus, magnetic length is always less than geometric length. The distance of each pole from the center of magnet is taken as small l. Thus, the magnetic length becomes distance of south pole L and distance of north pole L, L plus L equals to 2L. Magnetic axis. The line joining north pole, south pole and center of magnet is called axis of magnet. Equator of magnet. The line passing through center of magnet and perpendicular to its axis is called equator. Pole strength. The strength of a magnet to attract iron is measured in terms of a physical quantity called pole strength. It is generally denoted by letter small l. The pole strength of North Pole is taken plus M, whereas the pole strength of the South Pole is considered minus M. The SI unit of the pole strength is ampere meter. Magnetic dipole moment, capital M. The product of pole strength of any one pole and magnetic length of a magnet is called magnetic dipole moment. It is generally denoted by letter capital M and is given as magnetic dipole moment is equals to pole strength into magnetic length, that is capital M is equals to small m into 2L. The SI unit is ampere meter square.
Magnetic dipole moment, it is a vector quantity. In vector form, it is given as capital M bar is equals to small m into 2L bar, where 2L bar is a magnetic length vector directed from south pole to north pole. Thus, magnetic dipole moment M bar is directed from south to north.